out there again in YouTube and Radio Land. This is Ham Radio Man Oz. This is episode number 14. Some really interesting stuff to talk about today. I actually did this video a little bit earlier today, but I wasn't happy with the quality, and just prior to the uploading and that, I thought, no, I've got to try and sort this quality out a little bit better. So hopefully this quality will come through really good, even the screenshot stuff that I'm going to be doing for you, so that everything comes through nice and clear. So this is a re-record of episode 14 that I actually recorded earlier, but you won't notice that anyway. Alright, so the situation is, what are we dealing with today? Well, what today's topic is, what can you still do with your scanner? Because, let's face it, a lot of services now are going digital, and unless you want to keep forking out money for digital scanners, and I haven't got a digital scanner passe at the moment, I don't have one of them. What I do have is a trunk tracker, but I've never used the trunk tracking features on it. But, you know, like so many of us, I've been a radio enthusiast for a number of years, more than 30 years. I shouldn't say that because that's giving away my age. Oh, no! but you know, a lot of things have changed. Unfortunately, so is the hobby of scanning and what we used to listen to. And I used to love listening to the Police. Love listening to them chase down criminals and be right there with them and say, go get them, boys, you know, and listen to the chases and the sirens going off in the background. And, you know, it was so exciting. And you'd sit there and just, you know, you'd have everything going on. And if there was a criminal in your area, you could hear for the description of what that criminal was and who was chasing. And you might get out there and go, all right, I'll see if I can help the police here, you know. And it was a really fun part of the hobby. And you had the ambulance service and the fire service as well. Unfortunately, the criminals were listening in as well. And, I mean, I can't blame the police service or any other service for going to a digital mode, encrypted. It ruins the hobby for us in that regard, but it is secure for them. So I can't blame the services for going over to digitally encrypted services. One, for security. Two, for the safety of their members. And three, of course, so that their conversations are secure from criminals. So it's a loss for us on our hobby, but it's a win for the police services. And I suppose in the end, that's really what matters most. And sadly, I think the ambulance services have gone over to digital as well, so there's not a lot to listen to there. So who's next? The fireys? Well, I don't know. But as more and more services go digital, the less there is going to be to listen to on the scanner. You can still listen to aircraft, marine radio, and there's still a bunch of stuff out there to listen to. And, you know, it'll be a long time before everything, you know, go over to digital. So, you know, there's still a lot out there. But there are things that you can pick up on your scanner that we'll talk about. And one of them is pager signals. And you can decode these pager signals with a very simple piece of software. Now, basically, pagers have been around since the early days. I mean, since 70s, 80s, pagers have been around. I remember as a young businessman going to my first sales job, I had a pager on my hip and my mobile phone. And, of course, you know, the office would page you, and then you'd get a message whether you had to attend a meeting or ring in or whatever it was, and you picked up your great big Motorola phone that looked like this, and it was a brick. And I had a Mitsubishi Transportable that was very expensive, and it was like walking around with a car battery, and it looked like this. Imagine walking around with those. And you know, it was terrible. I was like leaning over because it was strapped over my shoulder so much, and the weight of the battery and the phone and lifting up the handset to my ear, the weight of it was pulling me over all the time. Yes, I can hear you. Hang on. So it was very funny indeed. But that was the way it was with analog. And of course, mobile phones have all gotten smaller and everything's improved a lot now with digital. And there's even digital devices you can get for HF radios as well now. And I believe also even the 2-meter radio as well. And one of these days I'll investigate and invest in one of these digital couplers for my HF radio Of course, on amateur radio, we don't encrypt them. But from what I've seen on YouTube and what I've seen and heard around the traps is that your conversations are certainly a lot clearer and there's less interference as well. So the digital side of things is certainly a big factor for a lot of radio systems now. Okay, but going back to pages, okay, you can receive and decode these pager signals, and it's very, very easy to do. Now, the pager system itself may eventually die out, and there may eventually be no more decoding there either. But in the meantime, there are still a lot of things out there. I've seen teachers calling in sick, schools running around trying to get replacement teachers. I've seen fireys communicating to their comms. I've seen ambulances communicating their comms. I've seen police communicating to other police. I've seen things like hot water companies, solar water companies. I've seen maintenance crews. There's all sorts of information out there still that you can look at, and it's rather interesting. And it's easy to pick up these signals because they're usually broadcasting them off the telecom towers or your mobile phone towers, and the signals are very, very strong, and there's a few different frequencies that you can tune in. But the beauty of it too is that you can pick up signals or pick up transmissions to these pages from anywhere in the country. So for example, where I am on the Gold Coast, I'm picking up messages on the pages that are coming out of Sydney, Melbourne, Adelaide, Perth. Doesn't matter where they are, a lot of Queensland of course, but the whole country, because they're all on this related telecommunication network. So wherever you are in the world, chances are you could pick up a lot of these pager signals from all around your country as well. So we'll get into it now and we'll have a look at the software. Okay, so first of all, we're looking at the piece of software that I use mostly is called POC32. It's a POCSAG, which is the protocol that they use, POCSAG protocol. And all I do with this one is simply leave it on auto and auto here as well. And when it decodes a signal, the little icon over here will light up. Now, basically, all you have to do with this one when you first install it, now it is shareware, and it will work for a while, and you can register it by purchasing it. It's not very expensive at all. This will do POCSAG and Flex. Flex is another type of decoding I don't have anything to do with at the moment, mainly because I don't think there's any Flex really around that I can receive. If there is, and anyone knows of any Flex frequencies or Flex radios going on around Brisbane, the Gold Coast area, or any other parts, or they've decoded Flex before, please send me some comments about that too, because I'd love to know what you've got in the way of Flex. But I'm just dealing with POCSAG. We just go into properties, and if we go over to the hardware tab, now these programs actually allow you to transmit as well if you have a pager sender. One of these days I might even examine the fact of how to maybe send a signal over the HF radio, a pager signal over the HF radio, experiment and see if I can actually do that. I'll have to check the regulations on the transmission type, whether or not I'm allowed to do that, but I'll certainly like to know if I could experiment with that way. But we'll see how we go. But all I've done here is enable the sound card, as you can see, chosen my input, and the number of channels. In this case, I'm only using one. Leave error correction off, FIR filter audio with just standard. This is all I've had to do is enable the sound card and change the channel. So we just cancel that out because I've already got that applied. Now, it's as simple as this. One thing you have to do, I'm using a discriminator tap on my scanner, and that's a very strong audio source coming straight into the computer. So because it's straight into the computer and it's a strong audio source, I need to make sure that the microphone input I'm using, which is, I think this one was, yeah, this is the one I'm using. So because I'm using a discriminator tap, I have it set on 1, sometimes 2, but it's on 1, that's the lowest level possible. But that actually is what works, because I'm getting such a strong audio signal into the computer from the scanner, I don't need any more than that. You might have to adjust it if you're using your speaker output or your line output from your scanner, you'll not only need to adjust the volume of your scanner, but you'll need to adjust the volume of your input line in or microphone input that you're using. Now, if I turn my scanner on, I don't even need volume on my scanner. I just turn my scanner on and it automatically goes to my default frequency for receiving that. And as it decodes, there we go, messages start to come up. Now, at first, messages might not make any sense. They might just look like gibberish. And a lot of them will look like gibberish because they're just codes or just something that, you know, doesn't make any sense. It doesn't really matter, because if you keep watching long enough, you'll see eventually some simple messages. There we go. We have one there. Something about abnormal behavior. There's an address. There's another one there. Please advise of any delays. Thanks. And Dr. Cat in attendance. So there's doctors, there's ambos, there's all sorts of things out there. But you can see quite clearly, they're just normal messages, and they're coming through quite okay. Okay, and they will come through fast and fast and fast. So, you know, you can sit there and just watch it all night. So that's very, very simple to do. And that's all you need. Now, there is another piece of software you can use called PDW. I'm not going to get into that one because that does ACARS, ERMIs, Mobitex and all that. But I find that for myself, POC32, nice and simple, works, no hassle. PDW seems to be a little bit sensitive, and I have to fiddle around with volumes all the time. I can get it working, but I find it's better for ACARS. So I use that one for ACARS, and I'll show you that at another time when I do an ACARS episode. I'll also be doing a video soon on receiving and tracking the aircraft through your normal scanner. Very, very easy to do. Actually, I'll be using a dongle for that. Get that right. I'll be using a dongle to show you how to track aircraft, and using a piece of software called AbSharp. Now, you may already know how to do that. You may already be familiar with that side of things. You may have seen that on other videos and already be doing it. But for those of you who don't know, you can track the aircraft in your area. And that's quite interesting to do too. Another exciting part of the hobby. But there's still a wealth of information that you can pick up on a scanner, and this is just one example of them. So there you go. Check that out and see what you think. So there you have it, guys. Very simple, very easy to do. It's not very hard at all. And for more information, check the links that I've put below in the videos on discriminated taps for your various scanners. And, you know, this can be done also. Discriminated taps can be put on virtually any radio. Shortwave radios even use discriminated taps. But check the links below for information about your scanner or how to do it. If you're not sure how to use a soldering iron or tapping into the discriminator tap, so you don't want to go that extreme, it's all right. You can still use the line out or speaker out, extension speaker output on your scanner. You just need to control those volumes a little bit more. Okay, so once you've got that all sorted, everything's sweet. Okay, this is Ham Radio Man Oz, and I'll be saying 73s. Please give me a big thumbs up, rate the video, comment, subscribe. Please don't forget to subscribe. Mention me along to your friends and other contacts that you have. Tell them to come and watch these videos. And we've got more exciting stuff coming up in the next few episodes. We've got all sorts of software reviews. We've got test equipment reviews. I've got oscilloscope test reviews. I've got signal generator reviews coming up. So there's a whole lot of stuff and some projects. I'm going to piece together some simple projects for less than $5, projects for less than $15, and so on and so on. So, you know, there's a whole lot of stuff coming up. So stay tuned to this YouTube channel, Ham Radio Man Oz. Mark it in your subscription list and mention it to your friends. And I'll see you next time. 73s, cheers.